Hi, I'm Dr. Tony Mork, author, speaker, inventor, board-certified orthopedic surgeon. I'm also an endoscopic spine specialist. And for the past 13 years, I've dedicated my practice exclusively to the treatment of painful neck and back conditions without the use of a fusion. I ask a question, what the heck is endoscopic laser spine surgery anyway? I mean, what am I talking about that's different than other types of spinal surgery being performed? Well, have you ever been faced with progressive or chronic neck or back pain? Maybe even with pain that goes down the arm or the leg, and it just won't seem to go away. You may not be aware of how it began, and you may have enlisted other healthcare professionals to help relieve that pain. Chiropractor, physical therapist, massage therapist, but regardless, all the treatment has been unsuccessful. You may have even tried medications, but they only take the edge off and doesn't really solve the problem. Well, I think that this is not such an uncommon problem, and you may have even considered a surgical option, but we're not really sure what the MRI was meaning when it said a disc herniation or stenosis. So it became a little unclear about what you had, and then the surgical options may have also been unclear. You may have heard surgery stories of success or not so successful, but we're unsure about what surgery was giving which result. Well, I wouldn't feel alone in this state of confusion. Many years ago, when I was a knee and shoulder surgeon, I asked my senior partner, who was a very experienced spine surgeon, to explain to me the difference between all the different kinds of back surgeries. I just didn't understand it. And with a lot of wisdom and perspective, he looked at me and he said, well, that's simple. And I said, really? And he said, yeah. I said, well, what do you mean simple? He said, well, Tony, he said, there's only two things you can do to a spine. You can either fuse it or you can decompress it. And I looked at him, I said, wow, that's it? It's that simple? He said, yep, it's that simple. And since then, in the past 20 years, we've had a few additions. There's been a disc replacements, and then there's been emphasis on neurolysis or neuroablation with particularly RF kind of generators. So those have also been added into the mix. But the basic components of spine surgery are either decompression or fusion. And fusion can also use decompressive techniques as well. So we have two surgical options, really, the fusion or the decompression. And I think that it really turns out to be a very philosophical consideration, because one technique is involved with removing portions of the spine to take the pressure off of a painful nerve or structure, whereas the other one is devoted to removing all motion from a segment, a spinal segment, and with the philosophy being if there's no pain, there's going to be no motion and no pain. Each group, I think, is pretty convinced that they have the correct approach to things. Let's take a look at fusion. The goal of a fusion is to remove all motion, either with a bone graft or an implant, to remove all motion at a certain spinal segment. And once this is done, the idea is that if there's no motion, there can't be any pain. A fusion can also incorporate some decompression into the operation as well, and it can also prevent what they call instability, which is abnormal motion, although it's very difficult to define. I think that current day spine programs are, they successfully train surgeons in how to use all the different techniques of fusing a spine, they're trained very well to do this. I think that spine fusions would be my first recommendation in many situations, including trauma and things like deformity, scoliosis, and conditions where there's absolutely no, you have a painful disc in the back, but there's no joint, there's no space left, the disc is absolutely shot. And I think that, a fusion has a real good purpose and value here. On the other hand, a decompression is a selective opening of the spine with trying to minimize any kind of contact or kind of trauma to surrounding tissues. When a disc is approached, if that's the problem, or if there's bony stenosis in an area, it can be selectively removed to or decompress or remove pressure from the nerve that's causing pain down the arm or the leg. Oftentimes, you just don't need to take that much away. Taking a little bit, I think, sometimes is the trick. And it doesn't interfere with motion. I mean, a decompression type of an operation allows people to retain their motion after the surgery. And many times, the motion will even be increased, because once the pain is gone, then the motion can actually increase and doesn't really affect the sharing of motion other levels, because the area operated on retains its motion. So no other burden of motion is placed on the surrounding disc levels. So I think that endoscopic laser spine surgery is the ultimate decompressive type of surgery, a procedure for many conditions that cause pain in the spine, including disc herniations and stenosis, facet syndrome. And I think the benefit is that there's no loss of motion. I mean, the idea of a decompression is to retain the motion and relieve the problem, not to eliminate the motion. I think that this is the big divide for, and the big philosophical dividing point for spinal surgeons is, I'm going to fuse them and make them stiff. Do I believe that there's no pain and if there's no motion? Or do I believe that I can selectively remove the area that's causing the problem, pain, affecting the nerves or the spinal canal size, and selectively decompress this without disturbing other tissues in the area? So that's the big question. Hey, thanks for looking at this video. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up, or share it on Facebook, or leave me a comment in the comment box. If you have other questions, please visit me at drtonymork.com. And thanks again for looking at this. Appreciate it.